All right, we are here with Chris Beatty at the Galaxy of Stories Pavilion at Disney's D23 Expo. Chris, tell us what your official title is.
My official title is Executive Creative Director for Walt Disney Imagineering.
All right, now we are here a couple of feet away from the big Star Wars model that we're going to see at the theme parks. Can you tell us about this model, who designed it, and what your role in this was?
Well, my role in the project is really, I'm one of several executive creative directors who are in charge of bringing the story and the narrative and the overall look and feel of the planet to life. Amazing thing about this project is we partnered with Lucasfilm, so this isn't a just solo WDI, job. It's been really an amazing partnership with Lucasfilm, with Doug Chang and the design team there, with the story team at Lucasfilm. So we're crafting this planet, this place that we're going to take you on the edge of the galaxy, together. And that's what's been really exciting is it's got that Star Wars DNA. It's got an amazing experience that guests are just going to love.
Oh yeah, we're loving it already. Is there any chance we can just go walk into that model there just to say we've been there?
Into that, it'd be kind of hard.
I'm thinking like Godzilla
right now. Yeah, like Godzilla. We feel like that from time to time when we're building these models because we're climbing around them, right? And you feel like you're like Godzilla or King Kong.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of fun. And the model you guys are seeing here, it's taken about just over probably a year to build this model. And we start, the process, we start with all kinds of models, like the really small ones, just to work out, what we want the experience to be, how we want relationships of buildings and the rock work to look. And then they just get bigger and bigger. And so the model you're seeing here is our art director's model. This model will actually end up going into the field as we start construction of the land.
Wow. Now, is this something that Disney went to Lucasfilm with or Lucasfilm went to you with? How did this start?
It started really together. We sat down at the table and the first question we ask ourselves is, where do we want to take our guests? What experiences do we want to give our guests? And we talked a lot of things. We said, we could go and we could build a Tatooine. We could go and we could build Coruscant. And at the end of the day, we kind of decided, those are really other people's stories. You think about Tatooine, it's really the Skywalker story, right? That was Luke's journey. And we decided that was not the direction we wanted to go. We really wanted the guests, when they enter into this land, for it to be their journey, right? That they become the hero. Now, when you go in the land, you're going to see characters and droids and creatures and things that you recognize, right, that are part of that adventure. But you are the hero when you go here. And that really excited us. That was sort of the genesis of the idea. And from there, we said, well, if we're going to do that, then we got to take you to a place you've never been before, this brand new planet on the edge of wild space.
I'm literally getting shivers listening to this.
So I have a question for you. We were here observing the model earlier, and there are two or three areas. And can you tell us about these different areas?
Sure. So the land, this outpost, really kind of sprung up. The backstory for this is it's this remote outpost where a lot of the bounty hunters, the rogue adventurers, these smugglers have come. And it's a place where you can get, your tech or maybe pick up a job or, go on an amazing adventure, jump out into deep space. But really the heart of this, of the land really is the outpost. And so the buildings that you're seeing, a lot of the, have a lot of shops and dining within them. The backdrop, of course, you can see the main, the main hangar bay has a ship that's very, very familiar to you, the Millennium Falcon. And that's really the entrance into one of our two signature attractions. And there we're going to let you go in, pick up a job as a smuggler, and climb aboard the Millennium Falcon, walk those hallways, sit down in the same seat as Han and Chewie, grab the controls, and shoot across the galaxy in an amazing adventure where you are the space pirate in the story. Our second signature attraction, we're opening with two, which is amazing. We normally don't do that for a land open with two signature attractions, but Star Wars, it's big, and so you got to go big or go home, right? So for our second signature attraction is located way out into the woods, just outside our remote outpost, where we find the Resistance, and they're encamped out there, waiting for their next mission, which we get to be a part of, and that attraction is going to put you right in the middle of that epic conflict between the Resistance and the First Order. So two rides are just going to blow people away when we open. It's going to be awesome.
All right, so those are two rides. How many rides will there be in all?
Just two total. Two. Yeah.
Well, really, it's about exploring the area, too, not just the rides, right? So I know there's like a First Order area. Is that like a whole different section of the park?
Yeah, I mean, if we do our jobs right, and I believe we are going to, the land itself will really be that third attraction. I mean, it's so rich. There's so much. I mean, you just look at the model, and there's all kinds of amazing places to get lost, little, like, pathways to wander through, and, you know, every door, there's something behind every door, you know. Food and beverage and merchandise really become that third experience. And so we're excited. We're not sharing a ton of details as to exactly what's going on inside those experiences yet. But that really is that third attraction that our guests will really, really love to explore and have fun with. I think if you look at Pandora, the world of Avatar, the land itself, that's a great example of the land being this attraction, right? That, you know, it's just, there's a spectacle when you enter into it, and it's just a place you want to get lost and explore. And that's what we're trying to do here with our new land.
Yeah, I can already see a lot of the signature designs from Star Wars veterans. Can you tell us what veterans actually worked on this?
You know, our design team is partnered with Doug Chang and his design team up at Lucasfilm, and, you know, he's one of the lead designers up there, and so we're tapping into all their artists. The same artists who are working on the films have been working with us on this project and creating some incredible artwork that you see around you in the pavilion today. And so that's really been, you know, people have asked me, you know, what's one of the, you know, the greatest things about working on this project. It really is that partnership with the Lucasfilm team. They're incredibly talented. And so what we've done is taken the best of Imagineers that we have and partnered with the best of Lucasfilm to bring you what you see here today.
And right now we're listening to Star Wars music, but, well, we won't hear Star Wars music in this Adventureland.
Music plays a big role in Star Wars. I mean, think about it. John Williams' theme is, like, epic, right? And so I'm not saying you won't hear music in the land. You'll have to wait till 2019 and find out.
So then John Williams has visited this planet and left a couple of CDs behind.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if John's actually been to the planet or not.
Just
but
tapes.
Yeah. You know, I think, like I said, music is a big part of it. You know, we have 2 years left, and so a lot of those details, things like, you know, the music, what you're eating, what you're, you know, the merchandise you're going to be purchasing, those things are still being worked on, and so it's still pretty early, even though we're sharing with you this amazing model. You know, there's still a lot of things left to share in the near future.
Now, can I ask one more question, or
yeah,
one more question and a half? Now, what is your biggest contribution to this new upcoming land experience?
You know, I lead an amazing team, and I think my biggest contribution is just being a shepherd to that team, right? And making sure that all those designers, the Imagineers, and the Lucasfilm, you know, people are feeling like they are empowered, they're engaged, they're highly creative, and getting that team to come together and foster that creativity and feed that creativity is something that is, you know, it's a lot of work, but it's a passion, and
You're
it's something.
Modest.
No, it's the truth. I think if you ask any Imagineer, we'll tell you it's never one of us. It really is a collective. And I, now working with Lucasfilm for a couple years, it's the same up there. They're incredible. I can't rave about them enough. And so the team is incredible. And that's really, like I said, it's an honor to be a part of that. So.
Now it's not just you being modest?
No, it's not me being modest.
All right, one more question. I noticed out here in the lobby that there's an Ithorian creature, which is something we don't see in Force Awakens or Rogue One. Whose idea was it to bring back classic creatures?
You're going to see, in the land, you're going to see all that. You're going to see, just think about it. No matter where you enter into the franchise, for me, the original trilogy is my Star Wars, right? But for my son, who's 8, Star Wars for him is episodes 7, 8, 9. It's Rogue One, right? It's the clone series. So he came into the franchise at a different point. So his lens that he sees Star Wars through is completely different than mine. As we concepted this land, we have to make sure that no matter who comes in the land, it feels like their Star Wars. So you're going to see characters from the past. You're going to see characters from, you're going to see characters you don't even know exist yet, right? The land has to be flexible enough to take new characters that come out in the future, but also have a home for characters from the past. And we'll make sure that happens.
Wow. And you believe you should never land on Alderaan, right?
No, you shouldn't land on Alderaan. That's probably not a good idea. It's probably just a little rock floating in space now. There's not much left of it, right? I mean, come on.
The man knows his stuff. All right. Thank you. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
All right. Take care.
My